Alright, so welcome to my short little screencast here. I'm going to provide you with one of my absolute favorite extensions on my MacBook Pro. So I am using a brand new MacBook Pro here, and this is something that I use almost all the time, both professionally and personally. And what it does, it's going to actually override my system preferences for my energy saver. So the first thing I'm going to show you is what that looks like. So if I take a look at my system preferences, click on energy saver, and right now you can see I'm plugged in, but my power adapter and my battery are almost identical. So what you're going to see is I'm going to have my computer go to sleep, put the hard disk to sleep whenever it gets a chance on battery, and then pretty similar on battery. You'll see my display, I do have it to turn off after a minute. That's just in case if I walk away, after a minute it will put itself to sleep, which I appreciate having. Now, I have this set and I don't have to worry about it because I use an app called Amphetamine. Now, you can download this from the MacOS App Store. So if I open up the App Store and begin typing in the search, it's going to be the very first thing you're going to see. It's a free app. There's no ads, nothing like that. It's one of the highest rating apps that is super helpful, and it's just great to really have. So here it is. You can see that I've already got it installed, which I will show you that next. So if I click on my launchpad, here it is. Here's the logo for it. I do know that the word amphetamine is a little weird to have, but it truly is a very helpful extension. So I have mine set to look like a coffee pot. So here it is. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually show you some of the settings before I get into what this fully does. So if I click on preferences, here I can set it to a default session duration. I set that as indefinitely. The status bar icon, click actions, so I can show menu or start the and or end the session. I can in here also allow the display to sleep or start the screensaver. Now I don't have those checks because essentially if I have my app running, I don't want that to be, I don't want that to happen. So launching behavior, I do want to, as soon as I log into my computer, to have that app open up. I don't want to start a new session because what I want is I actually want to trigger this on and off. So I don't want this to just set itself to turn on. I don't put it in the dock and I don't log anything. Triggers, so this is pretty cool too. So when I connect to different Wi-Fis and things like that, I can have this automatically turn on as well. Battery, so ask to end sessions if the battery percentage is low. So I can have it essentially turn itself off if I hit 10%. The drive alive, so again, looking at keeping my drives awake and things like that, I can set a hotkey. I have notifications, so I can turn those off if I want, but I appreciate having the notifications on. And then finally, the appearance. Now, you can have this set to however you would like. I thought coffee, the coffee carafe was just really fitting for me. I could use some custom icons, but in my case, I just like the coffee carafe here. Now, I can close this, and it's still going to be running in the background. So because my coffee carafe is empty right now, it's not technically running. So if I click this and click on indefinitely, what you're going to see is a notification, and my computer will then not go to sleep. So let's do that. So there you go. So a new session started, your Mac will not sleep. So you can see my little icon changed. And in this case, it is set to indefinitely. You see the little infinity logo as soon as I hover over that. I can also change this to minutes, hours. I can custom do this. If I were in iMovie or GarageBand or anything like that, I can have this turn on while an app is running. And then I can officially just quit this as well. Now I don't need to quit this to end my session. What I need to do is just end the current session. And then this reverts all the way back to my normal MacBook settings, which again, I find truly, truly helpful. So hopefully you got something out of this. This is again, one of my absolute favorite extensions for my MacBook Pro. And I think you would really appreciate it as well.